I think for kids, it's really important that if they start to pay with not with real money, but also with cards, that they have this overview. Because if you pay by card, it's really easy to forget how much did I already spend, for what did I spend this money. And we see the trend going from cash to cards, or either like you can pay by watch today. So it's easier and easier to pay. It's really frictionless to pay. So we think it's really important to have an overview for what you spend your money.
Today, as you said, we have money apps, custodial accounts, virtual money boxes. How does this help kids understand the concept of money? I mean, I have coins in my hand. It's not the same. It's not as tangible as having figures on a screen.
That's exactly the challenge, right? When we grew up, we got like, I don't know, 20 francs from our parents. And if I would spend 5 francs, I had 15 francs in my hand. So, and that changed today. If I got like money on my bank, it's just a number on a database. And that's much harder to get as a kid, or also as a young person, what that means.
So how do you tackle that challenge?
In our case, with an app. So with our app, you just log into the app, and then you see this, for example, this chart where you see what did I already spend. Or you can even create a budget that you get a notification. So you say, I want to spend, let's take the rest, the example from before, I want to spend only this amount for restaurants. So as soon as you spend more, you get a notification. So you get notified by your app that you already outspend your budget.
And why target the young generation?
We think there it's really important to learn what it means to spend money. As I said, like to pay is more and more without any frictions. You just keep your watch on a terminal and you pay it. So we think it's really important to get this feedback also from a digital channel, how much you spend and what you spend your money for.
You work with many banks here. How important is kids banking in Switzerland today?
I think it becomes more important. I think like most banks first focused on a general solution for in their e-bankings, and now we see banks also going into directions of offering special versions for kids. We also did a study together with Viseca where we asked parents where they see potential issues, and one issue is really like kids from 13 to 16, they can't get any credit cards today.
Isn't there a risk that giving them these tools so at such a young age, I mean, there's some danger? I mean, they get in trouble.
I agree, but the question is what's the alternative? Because we are in a society where if you want to buy an app, buy a song, buy a game, you need a credit card. And the alternative is to use your parents' credit card. And then you don't learn the things because it's just booked away from your parents' account. So I think it's going in the right direction to learn from a young age how money works, how digital money works, and what the impact is. Because with such a special credit card for kids, you could say, as a parent, you could say, how much can I spend on a category, for example? And as soon as you spend more, it's blocked. So you will feel that you cannot buy anymore, right?
So there are some safeguards that are put in place in your software, in the services that you offer.
Exactly.
What are they?
Like the one thing is are these budgets where you get a notification, but you can still buy, right? The things we are looking at now is exactly that you could really also have a hard block. So the parent would say, this is the limit, let's say 100 francs a month. And for those categories, I want to block the card. So you could not go and buy, like gamble in a casino, for example. And for those categories, I want to limit it to a certain amount. And then you have this in the card and you cannot spend more. So you could do such things with modern credit cards today.
Talking of the clients you work with, do we know the amount of virtually managed money on these accounts? Do we have any figures?
I don't have any real figures. I mean, we see a trend going in that direction every year. More is managed digitally and is also paid digitally, but I wouldn't have any figures.
There's a recent study in the Netherlands that says 75% of kids now have their pocket money on a bank account. You're expanding abroad. How do you assess this potential?
I think for us it's a potential because if banks see that this field is interesting and that they can win new clients, not only like children, but the children with their parents, because it's always a tandem. I think for banks, it's a really good new opportunity to win clients.
So where is this trend taking us?
I think it's interesting because when we were young, you would get like physical money from your parents, right? You would put them in, you would push till they go in, and then you would know what's in your piggy. But I mean, today you just get a transfer on your bank account and it's there virtually. And if you just have a card and pay, it's really hard for you to understand what that means. And but the trend clearly goes in that direction, that more and more is not paid with cash, but with cards or even with wearables. So I think we need to go with the time and also have the tools to do that.
Should we throw the piggy bank away?
It's hard to say. It's hard to say. I mean, it's moving quite fast. I mean, we moved from money to digital money, and now we have also the whole crypto hype, right? And I think we need to move with the time, and we cannot say, okay, I'll just keep teaching my children how money works, but then as soon as they are 16, they have digital money and they don't know how that works. So I think it's important, yeah, that we move with the time.